Right. Now, you guys watch it from a TV perspective.
Right.
So you see something different than what I see from a field level perspective.
From a field level and a former NFL player.
On top of that perspective. I guess that would help add some credence to it as well.
Maybe just a little bit.
Yeah.
And what I saw was a lot of improvement, if I'm being honest.
It was exponential, the improvement. And the part that you miss, and I understand it because, again, some people just can't have a perspective if you haven't been through it and seen it and know it what real as opposed to bad looks like.
Mm-hmm.
So week one, Deshaun Watson is like, man, I just need to get through this game. I just need to get through this game. And you've had those moments in life where I just need to get through the day, right?
Right.
You're not trying to do anything extra. You're not trying to put any sauce on it, as we like to say. Mm-hmm. You just need to get through the day.
Right.
Yesterday, night and day experience from him as a quarterback standpoint. You saw leadership starting to take place in that he's rallying guys. Because last week, he needed guys to rally him. Encourage him and bring him forward and be like, all right, dog, you all right. You're going to figure it out.
We got you covered. Yeah.
We're going to figure this thing out. This week, let's go. In the huddle, the command, the presence, and the confidence, chest starts poking out as opposed to just walking, not with a shoulder shrug or hung over, because he didn't do that last week either, but you know confidence when you see it.
Right.
And he had an air about him this past weekend where can't say it was infectious because, no, they did not put a lot of points on the board.
No.
But there was a lot of reasons to why points weren't put on the board. One of the things was penalties.
That's the biggest thing, in my opinion.
On top of that, guys who normally we could depend on just weren't there. From one guy, to his credit, I believe Coop fought through injury.
Mm-hmm.
And it's hard to play at a high level when you're hurt.
Right.
But he tried.
He looked like he was hurt, too.
But he gave it a go. And, and credit him for giving it a go. Because some dudes be like, you know what? I got, not to be in his pockets, I got a lot of money coming my way.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to sit down and shut it down for the day. But he didn't go that route. He played a team player route of, I'm going to put myself in harm's way and potentially make myself look bad so I can at least be of service to my football team.
Or I might make it so I miss the next 2 weeks.
On top of that.
Yeah.
Right, and give him reasons to be like, maybe he's lost a step.
Mm-hmm.
But he wasn't thinking in those terms, so that was a good thing.
Yes.
But getting back to Deshaun and what I saw. So, no, I didn't see. I saw a guy who's now in preseason game number two.
Mm-hmm.
Going against a team that is playoff caliber, NFL championship caliber football team.
Yeah, and holding his own. Last year. Yeah.
Holding his own. So I didn't walk away from experience like, okay, and yeah, he threw the interception, and I get why he threw the interception.
Mm-hmm.
Those blind spots are still going to be there until the game slows down for
him. And I felt like he missed a few guys because he wasn't necessarily trusting what he was seeing. There was a DPJ kind of ran a route where the middle of the field was wide open,
and he
was
there.
And it looked like he saw it, but he just
middle field. I don't know. Yeah. So it's got to be a trap here.
He wasn't trusting his eyes.
Right. It's gotta be, somebody's got to be there lurking. And so when he finally did trust his eyes, he throws in an INT.
Right.
That's going to happen as well. But the part, and yeah, I'm being an apologist for him right now. The Bengals have been 13 games in it. The Bengals are playing at a high level. Offensive, defensively, special teams, you name it, they're doing it at a high level. Though you can make a comment that McPherson is not holding.
Yeah, I was going to say, I don't know about special teams.
Yeah, but it is what it is. The whole point is he's in preseason game number two.
Mm-hmm.
They're in the full-fledged season. They're in season form. Maybe even mid-season form. They're in season form.
Yeah.
So I was encouraged by it. I did not walk away from that game whatsoever saying Deshaun Watson's presence on that football field as opposed to Jacoby Brissett cost us a football game. I walked away from that football game saying that we have way too many individuals on this football team who are concerned about getting their shine and who's concerned about making a play and who do the dumbest things at the wrong time that's costing us football games.